told me, Rose, come. Are you Rose Abdallah? I said, yes. This is what he said. This is what God has told me to tell you. That whatever you consider shame, he will use it for his own glory. And the man went. I wanted more explanation. How did you hear God? Because me, I also wanted to hear God. Was it on a loud voice? How do you? I wanted to hear God telling me by himself, not telling other people. So my perception was God needs to talk to me. Now, please remember that so after I applied, I was called and I was asked by the admissions office, what else have you done? You know, this is too low, da, 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 because I didn't qualify. Even that diploma, it was supposed to be a C. Mine is a D. So I told them that it is circumstances and I promise that I will pass. I am very sharp and I really promised the admissions office and they took me in. Please note that I don't have school fees to go to school. So I am there and I'm wondering how I will go to school. But I got a scholarship with an organization called Kenya Help. I got a scholarship to go to school. Now, when I just went to church one day, as my usual, just going to church for practice, for dance or something, it was normal that I go to church. And let me tell you, church people are tricky. That is very hard in the way. So I went to church. And I was told, well, congratulations, you have received a scholarship. This is a scholarship that I did not apply for, but I got the scholarship anyway. Then a story arose in church. What? That I come from a Muslim family. That was not a lie, it was true. You know, there's few people that you share with your story, they can actually turn it around. So I just shared with somebody, confided in somebody that I come from a Muslim family. Not anything beyond that. So they said that I come from a Muslim family. My character is in question, I don't qualify. Because this was a church scholarship, I don't qualify. Because I come from a Muslim family. And I have run away from my family. I'm living with a married man. I'm cohabiting. Those are things that are not acceptable in church. Do you know me? I didn't know that I was living with a married man. So an investigation was launched of me being questioned of living with a man. Apparently they were asking everybody else apart from myself. But anyway, when they were done, they gave me the scholarship and I said I will not keep it. Because I didn't understand why people would just come up with a story. And which is this married man that I was living with? So, long story short, somebody talked to me. As I said, I was surrounded by many couples that told me, do not allow your destiny to be deterred by what people think of you, because it was proven that it was not true. I accepted and I went to school. I went, did my diploma, did that diploma. I got a distinction, passed, and then that scholarship was extended to bachelor's. I did bachelor's, and then while doing bachelor's, I got what took me to Bible school, because I was going to question God. We did a course by one of our lecturers called Theology of God, and it got to a point where we were doing sovereignty of God, and the sovereignty of God, there's a statement that hit me hard on the questions that I was trying to ask God, that God is the controller of the universe. He does whatever he pleases and wills, with anyone at whatever time, and he is not answerable to anyone. Then I realized I actually cannot question God. Whatever he did with me, it was out of his own sovereignty. We went for prayer meeting, like still in bachelor's. I used to go to pray with some Nigerian boys. Of course, I kept a lot a company of boys. 95% of my friends are men. I don't know why, it just happens. So we went to pray in chapel in one of the prayer rooms, and I met there a Nigerian man that I have never met again. And he called me after the prayer and told me, "Rose, come. Are you Rose Abdalla?" I said yes. This is what he said. This is what God has told me to tell you. That whatever you consider shame, he will use it for his own glory. And the man went. I wanted more explanation. How did you hear God? Because me, I also wanted to hear God. Was it on a loud voice? How do you? I wanted to hear God telling me by himself, not telling other people. So my perception was God needs to talk to me. So he left. But I took that word to heart. So God, you are saying my being in the streets, you will use it for your glory? So God, you are saying my BFGM, you will use it for your glory? God, you are saying that sexual assault, let me call it by you, you allow me to be raped to use it for your glory? Hey, you must be a funny God. So I kept on asking. So while at AIU, I joined a prayer, I joined missions team for Sitam Woodley through friends that used to go to Sitam. And we went for a mission in Mozambique. While in Mozambique, I met a 17-year-old young man when we were doing door-to-door. He was white. So I met him, and we just passed each other because we were preaching the gospel. But when he went, he stopped he was cycling and called me by name. "Are you Rose Abdalla?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Come, I have something for you." So I thought probably this is a member of the churches that we have been going to, so probably there's something I forgot or something. He said, "God has sent me to you." And he says, "Rose. Rose is a beautiful flower with thorns. So anyone who does not want to be hurt by the thorns does not go near roses. So just as your name is Rose, your life is a lot of thorns. And God says, he has put thorns in your life for a purpose so that not everyone would come to you because you are too tender. So when they come and try to touch your beauty, then the thorns will scare them away. And only those that will not be scared by the thorns will stick." And the guy went. I want him to tell me, how did this God talk to you that he cannot talk to me? Sijui kama, I don't know if anyone understands me, but why is this God telling other people about me? See, he tells me. Why is he? But anyway, he disappeared. Again, I took that word to heart. And we finished our mission in Mozambique, came back. With time, I have seen what God meant. I have seen that very few people are able to know your weaknesses, to know your strengths, and still consider you a friend. I have seen that everything from childhood to where I am currently, it is God's story. Actually, I don't say I have a testimony. I say God has written a story in me that He uses for His own glory. If that glory, whatever that glory is, I still do not know. But He knows because He's a sovereign God. I know for sure that if I wasn't sexually abused, if I had not gone through all these bad things in the hands of my family, I would not be a believer today, trust in me. So, in as much as it is painful, it is bad, God used this to show me the loving grace of God. God allowed me to be hurt badly so that I may know that He heals the brokenhearted. God allowed me to be accused, because if I wasn't accused, I think I would be part of the people that accuse others, so that I would not be among the people that accuse others. God allowed me to carry a pregnancy and to be a single mother, so that even as I do what I do currently, as I interact with these people, I will not be among the group that will judge single mothers, among the group that will see a guy expectant and raise a finger on them. Why? Because I have walked that journey. I have walked that journey outside church, and I've walked that journey within church. Even today, there are people that question. There are people that think Rosie is not qualified to mentor any girls. Why? Because she got a child out of wedlock. There are people that think about it. There are people that say that. But you know, for me, it is God's doing in my life. Because it is in that weakness that God takes the glory. And I've received messages, people asking me, help me to help my brother to get out of drugs. I don't know how to help them. I can only pray for them. I don't have 10 steps on how to help them. I can only tell them, Jesus, 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 because that is what I know. If you're beyond into severe addiction, then you need to go see a counselor. But as I sit today, I see beauty in ashes. I see God. I now fully understand in my life that in all things, the good and the bad, the ugly and the beautiful, God does good. Everything that the enemy purposed for bad, God turned it around for good. Currently, even as in my life as a believer, and I've been a believer now for like 10 years or so, even the accusations that I got as a child, I still get them. I still get them. Ah, you've been married for 5 years and you have a big child. You are once a drug addict. You don't have the moral authority to tell people to walk in sexual purity because you are sexually impure. You don't have, you know, those kind of accusations. There are people that think they know you and would say anything about you. But this is what I know for sure. That God, who sits in heaven, you've been accused. We don't know why you're a single man, by the way. We don't know why you're a single dad. We don't know why your marriage broke. We don't know. People don't know about people's lives. But we are quick to speculate as long as we don't know. Let me let you know that even me, I face the same. Even me, there's a way I will behave towards some people, and people will begin to speculate. I have been accused of breaking a marriage in church. That I am having an affair with a married man. I have been accused of such. And let me tell you, when God stands out to defend you, everybody else steps aside. Child of God, be encouraged that God is your vindicator. Bye bye, and see you. I take a cup of tea.